I pray today that you would use this marriage to lead many people to you, and that you would be pleased today with all that's said and done. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated.
We're in Gadsden at River Rock Landing. Right now we're at Meredith's rehearsal dinner, Meredith and Noah's rehearsal dinner, getting ready to celebrate their big day tomorrow. So we're having dinner, and then we're gonna do the run through a little bit later just to prepare for tomorrow.
This turned out really well. I love it.
Just ready to be over with. Go ready for the honeymoon.
Mr. Muscles here. He has it under control.
Aaron's going to work with the propane and propane products.
Micah.
Nope.
I love you. I hope you're enjoying your big day. Are you okay?
Mm-hmm.
You're not crying or anything today?
It's been the easiest day.
Okay.
Everyone's just chill. That's how
I think we ought to do.
Yep.
From here, what does it matter? You know what I mean? Because it's
gotta
really it's all about you getting you and Noah together.
Room.
Yeah.
I did take the tag off.
Cufflinks, that is Lord of the Rings. That is my favorite series, book, TV show, whatever, of all time, ever. And we got Meredith. Meredith watched it a little bit from her dad, because her dad's a nerd too, like us. And but that's been mine and my dad and my brother's thing since the day we were born, pretty much. Since we could talk, walk, whatever, it's been Lord of the Rings. That's always been our favorite thing. So Meredith got me these Lord of the Rings cufflinks, which is the White Tree of Minas Tirith. And there's one for a tie as well, but since I'm wearing a bow tie, my dad is going to wear the one for the tie, the matching one.
So does the tree face me or away from me?
You won't, it'll go.
Would you suggest facing out? Or
I would face it out so that.
Face out?
What? Yeah.
Okay.
These screws, then you take that.
I need to get me a jewelry box, huh?
Take that and just turn it to the side.
I have two right shoes.
I would put my shoes on until the last minute.
It does?
For pictures and.
Oh, I'm excited. Very happy to have Noah join our family. And hopefully, he'll make my daughter happy for the rest of her life.
We're very glad, very excited with this union of Meredith and Noah. We're very excited to have Noah join in the family. He's been very good for Meredith so far. Thanks for everybody for coming.
Can I use that?
My phone's going off over there.
The hallway.
Where's that one coming from?
I
taking, babe.
Now, on the count of three, I want you to turn to your left elbow, okay?
Okay.
You ready? One, two, three.
I love you, husband. I love you, bro.
Stupid. Did you pat your chest, Sean?
Here, wait, I have something for you. Please keep this. For me. That's from me to you. Wedding gift.
Get the hell out of here. How's it going?
This is me.
He had girl hands, Meredith. He had girl hands.
He always does.
He's got girl hands.
Perfect. All right, staying with you a second ago. You're going to turn to your left, okay?
On count three. Number
one, two, three.
Yeah.
Thanks, buddy. I like it. Looks good.
Yeah, I can, like, see you. Okay.
For a look.
You look good.
For some?
Look at you. So sassy.
Oh, I love it. It's beautiful. I don't want to miss you, man. I love you, honey. Love you, okay. And I like your jewelry.
Yeah.
Where'd you get that?
Mama.
You look cold, though.
Very cold.
That bothers me.
Yeah. Very cold. I've seen him. I'm excited. Ready to get it over with.
But you still must decide each day that stretches out before you that you want to be married. It's with that thought in mind that I ask, who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother and I.
Thank you. It must be understood that the kind of love of which the Bible speaks about is not a sentimental emotion that can pass away with time, but it's a commitment of the will that lasts throughout all eternity. Noah and Meredith, if you're willing to commit to be the husband and wife that God would have you to be, would you repeat these vows after me? Do you, Noah, in the presence of God and these assembled witnesses, promise to love and to cherish in sickness and in health and prosperity and adversity this woman whose hand you now hold?
I do.
Do you take her to be your lawfully wedded wife as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Do you commit yourself to her happiness and her self-fulfillment as a Christian and her usefulness in the kingdom of God? Do you, Meredith, in the presence of God and these assembled witnesses, promise to love and to cherish in sickness and in health and in prosperity and adversity this man whose hand you now hold?
I do.
Do you promise to be to him in all things a true and faithful wife, to cleave unto him and him only as long as life shall last?
I do.
Do you take him to be your lawfully wedded husband as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Do you commit yourself to his happiness and his self-fulfillment as a Christian and his usefulness in the kingdom of God?
I do.
Noah, do you possess a token of your love and affection today to give to Meredith as a seal of this holy covenant?
I do.
Meredith. So having placed this ring on her finger, would you repeat after me? I, Noah. Take thee, Meredith.
Take thee, Meredith.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
I take thee for richer. For poorer.
For
better.
For better.
For worse.
For worse.
In sickness.
In sickness.
And in health.
In health.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Meredith, do you possess a token of your love and affection to give to Noah as a seal of this holy covenant? I, Meredith. Take thee, Noah.
Take thee, Noah.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
I take thee for richer or for poorer.
I take thee for richer or for poorer.
For better or worse.
For better or for worse.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
As long as we both shall live. Now, by the virtue of authority vested in me as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, and in the presence of God, these assembled witnesses, I pronounce that you are husband and wife. Noah and Meredith, you have given sacred vows to each other before a holy and a righteous God. These vows are never to be broken. God says, what he has joined together, let no man put asunder. Noah, it's my privilege today to tell you that you may now kiss for the very first time your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my privilege to have introduced to you Mr. and Mrs. Noah Harden.
Come to me on the day of my daughter's wedding, right, from the Godfather?
Yeah.
Yeah, so nobody made a request to the Godfather.
So, Bill, I'm going to do you this favor, but one day may come when I come to you for a favor, and on that day, I will not be refused.
Well, we got to do the whole, thank you, Grandma.
You call me Don Micah, by the way.
What was it?
Don Micah.
Don Micah.
Bride and groom, we got to cheers to the years, baby.
I wouldn't drive 2.5 hours for a wedding for nobody.
I know, they were freezing and ready to
untie. You don't build a body like this overnight. It takes years of work.
Would you call it, Mark? Denial.
Happily ever after.
Cousin, this is your cousin Ronnie. I just wanted to let you and Noah both know how excited I am for you guys and what a beautiful day it is for you guys to get married. And I pray that the Lord blesses both of you with a long and very happy marriage. God bless you both.
Noah, Meredith, happy to see that we're, you know, closing this deal. I can't wait to see where this goes from here. You know, y'all got a long, happy road ahead of y'all. A lot of stuff y'all gonna do together, raise a family together, and now you've got twice the family. So, can't wait to see where this goes.
So proud of you, Meredith, for finding somebody that you love so much and that loves you. And I'm so excited about seeing where you guys go in life and getting to raise my little niece and nephew. Yeah, I'm very proud for you guys and excited.
God bless your marriage. We wish you all the best. In the good times and the bad, just put God first in everything. And remember to always say I love you.
We love you so much and we're very proud of you guys.
I just want to wish them all the happiness in the world. And I truly hope that they both have found someone that completes them as much as their dad and I complete each other. I hope every day is a new day for you and that your love grows and grows as each day comes along.
Well, I wish you the happiest of times and the longest of life. Remember to be quick to forgive and slow to anger, and spend your life trying to make the other one happy. And that will make for a wonderful, wonderful life. And I look forward to watching you guys grow and having me a grandbaby. I'd love to see little Micah. Love you guys.